welcome to chat with me. I am so excited, and you should be too, because we have with us the talented, the beautiful, and the inspiring Miss Suze.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me, Robin. I'm just thrilled to be here.
I'm so glad you're with us. You have more talent in your pinky than I have in my entire body. So,
it's so funny because people always say, I can't even draw a stick figure. And I say, why would you want to?
That is true, because that's what they made us do back in the day. But Suze is an artist. She is an incredible and just talented artist. And you don't even stick to just one genre or one type of art. You do a lot of things. You've made beautiful murals for people in their homes, for businesses, for all kinds of stuff. And just recently, due to COVID and all of the things that we've been going through, you were inspired to do what?
Last week I was sitting around thinking what I could do for healthcare workers. I know a few, as we all do. And of course, the stories that I've been hearing on the news made me really think, what can I offer to people who are giving so much? And I thought, the one thing I can do is paint. So I went to Home Depot and I got an 8-foot piece of plywood, sanded it down and primered it, and I painted a mural on it. And over the weekend, my husband and I drove it down to Florida Hospital and dropped it off, put it in the center island there for everybody to see, to let them know how much we appreciate them.
How did you even come up with what you were going to paint?
Well, that is not my, that was not my original art. That I did see a version of that online. And I thought, that's it. It hit me. It gave me goosebumps. And I thought, well, maybe it'll do the same for somebody else.
It's so beautiful. And, you know, it represents, you know, the fact that there's everyday heroes that are out there just working their buns off to keep us all safe and healthy. And for you to, and I love that you sat there and you're like, what can I do? Well, I know what I can do. Well, what you can do is paint. And you did that. And it was just so beautiful. I love it. What kind of response have you had since you put it out?
You know, I put it on social media because I do have friends who have, like, one of my friend's daughter works down at that hospital, and I had no idea. And she went down on a break and took a picture of it and said how appreciative she was. And that just made me feel so good, just for one person to see it. And I think it may have been the way that we situated it. It may have been facing like toward the women's unit. So they turned it around so that the kids would see it at the children's hospital.
So. Oh, that's so beautiful. Now it's just even more because there's superheroes on there. So the kids are going to love that. But for them to see, I mean, it's a nurse or a doctor. It could be either, right? Because it's the way
it's made.
I love that. The kids are seeing these everyday heroes among these heroes that they've known and heard about and seen in the movies and all the cartoons for so long. So to them, that representation to me is so exciting and so important. And for our nurses and doctors that walk by it and see it, oh, what an amazing feeling. You could just have turned their entire day around just by that one beautiful sight.
I especially loved it because it was a woman. So
I did appreciate that as well. And again, that's why you could be a nurse or a doctor.
That's right. That's right. You can be anything you want to be.
Did you think about that for a minute before you painted it? Or is it just automatically in your mind always a female?
It was always a female.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we thank our men too, of course. We're appreciative of our first responders, all of our nurses and doctors, all the people on the front lines every day. We appreciate all of you.
Yeah, they're just doing so much. And, you know, like I said online, I can't imagine what they've seen and experienced in these last few weeks. And that's, you know, what I did is just a tiny thing to say how much I appreciate everything that they're going through.
Right. And I get that, but you can't minimize what the effect that has on people. So if everybody does that, if everybody was to tap into their specialty, their whatever it is they can do and put it out there in the world for that positive, just experience is great. I love it.
One person can make a difference. Absolutely.
I agree. So tell me a little bit about the mural. When you do something like that, you painted this big, you said 8 foot by what? What is?
4 foot.
Mm-hmm. 8 foot by 4 foot. When you do walls and buildings and homes, do you stencil it out first or do you just start painting? Like, what is the process for you?
I definitely have to draw it out first. Okay. Because there are times when I get it on there and I'm like, that's not what I was thinking, you know, and it doesn't happen very often, but sometimes, you know, we're human and we're not perfect, or we think this is going to look great. And because of the surroundings or the texture or whatever it may be, it doesn't look so great.
Yeah.
And that's fine. I mean, what I always tell my clients is it's just paint.
And it's more forgiving, you know, than people think.
It is. Yeah. It's not something that's permanent. You can always paint over it. We can start over if you don't love it, you know, but I try to make it, you know, to where I don't have to start over, obviously.
Right. But, that's fun to do that.
Yeah, that's not very fun. But I usually don't get very far either before I decide. It's usually me, not my client. It's usually me deciding, no, this is how it has to be. We have to change this. Yeah. And, you know, because of certain ways things are in a room, certain ways furniture has to be, I may have seen the room empty and I get there and there's a crib in it or there's, and I'm like, well, that wall is a no-go. Let's rethink this, you know?
Right. I love that. Is there a way that people can follow your art or get in touch with you if they're interested in a mural? Do you have a social media or?
I do. I have a Pinterest link for all of my murals. And then I also have a website, which I think you're going to link for me. And I've been doing murals for about 17 years now professionally. I was trying to add that up because my son was 20 this last week and I started when he was 3. So,
wow.
You know, when they're little, you're into all the fun kid things and you know all the characters, the, you know, for him it was Bob the Builder and Thomas and all those things. And now, you know, the older you get, your kids get older, you're not familiar with those things and I'm like, what's a Peppa Pig?
You know? So you have to research things now when people want it.
Absolutely. Aww,
that's adorable. Mm-hmm. Well, Susan, I appreciate you being here today. I definitely appreciate the time and effort and even money that you put into that project. I think you're really going to make an impact on a lot of people. I know you did for me. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you. And thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it. And I've always appreciated your support.
Oh, definitely. You've got it, girl. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you check out her stuff. And as always, take care of yourselves and don't forget to take care of each other.